It's Kristen and Bethany here with Girl Defined Ministries, and in today's vlog, we're going to be sharing with you something fun and practical, how to wear makeup in a God-honoring way.
Oh, this is going to be fun. Cheers.
Thinking back to when we first started wearing makeup and really just experiencing with makeup, we get like literally a comedy show just watching our old videos and looking at our pictures because we had no idea what we were doing.
It's a nightmare.
Oh, like I think I started out first of all with like this bright like purple eyeshadow. Remember the purple eyeshadow?
It was like shiny.
That's all I wore. Just like purple eyeshadow. Like, wow, I'm not sure what I was thinking. So I'm sure you look back on some of your pictures when you're younger and think, what was I doing? But I remember as I got a little bit older, we both went through this phase that we call the raccoon phase, where we thought that more eyeliner was better. Like, we thought as much as we could possibly get on our eyes, like, the better it would make us look. And so I remember one time we put so much on and we just thought like, wow, this is awesome, because we didn't know what we were doing. We didn't know how to wear makeup. And we were at this conference, and I remember this, we were talking to these girls. And this really, their dad came over and he was like being super sweet, and he's just kind of commented, do you remember this? And he's hey girls, like, y'all are such beautiful young women, but just like kind of a thought, like maybe if you wore less eyeliner, it would maybe enhance your natural features even more. And we were kind of like, what is this random dad like really giving us makeup advice?
Everything.
Oh, you know,
makeup.
Like when you're young, you think you know it all. And so that was a very humbling experience.
Well, because because it was our makeup was, it wasn't just like eyeliner. I wear eyeliner now, but it was like,
raccoon. Like, it was like black circle. So thankfully, we learned more isn't always better. And as we got older, we continued to learn and grow in our understanding of makeup. And then we started asking, like, what does God think about makeup? Yeah. What do other wise, godly women say about makeup? Yeah. So we did a lot of research. And in this video, this is going to be down to earth fun. At the end, we're even going to share, we're going to open up our makeup bags and just give you some of our favorite, like, show you some of our favorite products that we like to use. So we hope you find this practical and helpful as we talk about really how to wear makeup in a God-honoring way. So for me, when it comes to most things in life, I want like black and white answers. I'm very black and white, and I want to know what's right, what's wrong. Just tell me what to do, and I'll follow it. And when it comes to makeup, I kind of wanted the same thing. Like, wear this, wear, you know, you can wear lipstick, but no eyeliner. Okay, great, I can do that. Just give me the guide, and I will follow it. But when it comes to the Bible, there are certain things that the Bible is very clear about. Like, okay, having sex before marriage. That is a black and white answer. The Bible is very clear that sex should be saved through the marriage bed alone between one man and one woman. Like, there's no questions. And for me, I'm like, okay, that makes sense. I can follow that. But then when it comes to something like physical boundaries in a relationship, the Bible, maybe in a dating relationship, the Bible isn't like, okay, you may, you know, have 2 inches between you, one holding your hand, and that's it. It's like, it doesn't give that. It gives you the wisdom and the principles, and you see the black and white of saving sex for marriage. But besides that, it's like, you know, you kind of have to dig deep and use the wisdom that it offers. And in a lot of ways, that can be hard because you want the black and white sometimes. And so when it comes to the area of makeup, what we have to do is we have to take what scripture says about it, and then when we have to use that to as wisdom to kind of guide us and to kind of make decisions using what the Bible says, not adding to it, but not taking away from it. You mean the Bible doesn't have the back with the maps, like a guide for makeup, like tutorial?
Yeah, like it doesn't have that in the back?
I wish. That would be nice, like the perfect holy makeup.
Yeah.
Or nothing. But it doesn't do that. I'm sorry, this is so down to earth and casual, y'all. We're just having way too much fun with y'all. But we're hoping to share with you one of the main verses that we've read on the topic of makeup. A lot, you know, the verse you've probably heard before. Kind of discuss it, what we believe it means, and then hopefully gain some wisdom from that verse. So there isn't one specific verse that talks directly about makeup, but there are a lot of verses that talk about our design as women and then our design as Christians and how we can best honor God in our lives. So the verse that we've really looked at and that we're going to look at today really quickly comes from 1 Timothy 2:9-10. And this is something I'm sure you've all heard, but just listen up because the context is really interesting. It says, "Likewise also that women should adorn themselves in respectable apparel, with modesty and self-control, not with braided hair and gold or pearls or costly attire, but what is proper for women who profess godliness with good works." And so you might think, okay, wait, is this verse saying we can't wear like pearls or costly attire? Like, what does this mean? But when you dig into the context of this verse and you get at the heart behind what is trying to be communicated in this passage, what we see is that this was being written actually and directing towards the Christian women of that day, back in the day, in their culture, in their context. And what was happening is that there were a lot of women who would dress in ways, the pearls, the costly attire, that's referring to a lot of the ungodly men, women of the day. Really, the temple prostitutes would often dress in these kind of ways. And so essentially what this passage is saying and trying to communicate to even us as women today in our modern day is, hey, God's women, Christian women, should dress and act and look a way that represents holiness, that represents purity, that represents women who are set apart, women who reflect God in a beautiful way, but do it in a way with purity and holiness and hearts of humility. And that's where it should start, in our hearts. And so we can take that context and say, okay, for today, our outward appearance, God cares about more so he cares about our heart. And our hearts should, out of that, overflow how we dress, how we act. But it's so much more than makeup. It's makeup, it's clothes, it's everything about us. God wants us as women, as Christian women in this modern day and age, to dress, to act, to look in a way that reflects a heart of purity, holiness, and modesty. And so when talking about makeup, we believe and we've come to the conclusion that there are ways that we can enjoy makeup in a fun, God-honoring way that still portrays the purity and holiness that God is wanting for Christian women.
But because this is a wisdom issue and the Bible doesn't have that tutorial in the back with exactly what we should or shouldn't do, we know that we may land on different pages and or have different convictions in this area, and we totally know that, and that's okay. Really, the heart should be a heart that wants to honor God, and through that, wherever you land, make sure that that's your heart's motive. So whether you land on the page of like, you know, I don't feel like makeup is a good decision for me, my heart and just what I believe, I don't think that's a good one, that's fine. Or you may be someone who lands and says, yes, I think makeup is okay in the right context or in this situation. That's kind of not the point of should we or shouldn't we. It's really what we're trying to get at is the heart of, is your heart desiring to honor God? Is it a heart of humility, like Kristen said? Are we trying to look like the world, and are we trying to, you know, kind of appear kind of, you know, sexual or kind of, you know, raunchy or any of those sorts of ways? Or are we trying to honor God? So really just think about the heart's motive. Don't get caught up on the should or shouldn't, but really focus on the heart of what we're trying to say in this. But the one thing that we do see in scripture is that God created women to be beautiful. When Eve came onto the scene, it's like, wow, everything is good now. The curves, just everything about us. And you see, like, even the world gets this in the culture. Who are they putting on the fronts of the magazines? It's these beautiful women to showcase their beauty, not in typically a God-honoring way, but we need to realize, like, we were created to be beautiful creatures. Yes, we are. That beauty is a good and wonderful thing. And I am, like, as girly girl as they come. Like, to the core, I am, like, sparkles and pink, and that's just the way, personally, Kristen's not as much that way, but we both love to enjoy the beauty that God gave to us. And with makeup, we kind of view it as like, well, we do live in a fallen world, and along with that, we get some really dark circles, we get some acne, some pimples. Does anyone still in our late 20s and now 30s, pimples, what in the world? And so we view, just like deodorant, we use that to freshen up, or toothpaste to brush in that breath, or whatever, you know, lotions when we have brush our crusty hair. Skin, brush our skin. We kind of view makeup for us in that same sort of way. So if we have dark circles, we might cover them. And honestly, we both just enjoy makeup, enjoy enhancing the beauty that God has given us. So that's kind of our view on it. And that's what we love. Just don't feel like your beauty is a bad thing, or like, oh, I can't enjoy the beauty the way that God designed me. Like, oh, I need to hide it, or and this is a bad thing.
Yes. And not even enhancing it is a bad thing, that, oh, well, if God gave us natural beauty, then we should just leave it. But I think he gave us natural beauty, but like you said, we live in a fallen world, so enhancing it even highlights that. Yes. I think can highlight it even more. Yeah, it'd be fun.
It's super, super fun. And so because we have so much fun in this area, we thought it would be really fun to show off some of our favorite products. Now, we are not makeup professionals or makeup pros, but we just want to share with you a few things that we use that are really fun to help us enhance our God-given beauty.
We have been wanting to do this for a really long time. We know a lot of you have asked for makeup tutorials, and maybe we'll get to that someday, but for now, we thought it'd be fun just to show you some of the products, and we have a lot of really different products. So for me, I get really dark circles, like really dark circles.
For like, now, our whole life.
We're both very fair-skinned anyways, and so when we don't have makeup on, like, our faces kind of disappear. So what you use is going to vary based on your skin tone, your color, like how dark or light your features are. So because I get such dark circles, I use this stuff. It's going to be hard to see, but it's by MAC. It's Select Cover-Up Concealer. This stuff is strong.
Pause. I'm just going to borrow this from him. I don't think he's going to mind.
Than you. If you're a lipstick person like me, then I would recommend checking them out, because these have been super successful for my lips. Guys, we hope this video was fun and inspiring for you. And wherever you land when it comes to makeup, whether you believe it's God honoring for you or not, just remember, in scripture, we don't really see a black and white stance on this. So we each just need to pray individually and make a choice that we believe is going to best honor God with our appearance in a way that reflects holiness and purity. We hope giving you a peek inside of our makeup bags was fun and that this video was just enjoyable. Thanks so much for
watching today's video. If you like it, give us a thumbs up. And if you want to see more from us, you can subscribe to our channel below because we post new videos every Wednesday.
Bro, it's fucking duh. End of the video. Bye.
I think the heavens must have sent you.
God made us beautiful this way.